Hello, welcome back to Operation Urban Sword this time. I'm going to be assaulting these three locations, like we said last time, and the intention is to try and create a borderline over here before we go and attack the town of Katkoula. If you didn't see the previous episode, this is a liberation map, a big capture the island map that covers all of this, an extended campaign, and I'm using the British Armed Forces. I've got a whole set of mods that allow us to play using the Special Boat Service and the Royal Marine Commandos. I finally got some vehicles, so we can move a little bit faster this time, although we won't be using the vehicles in combat just because we don't have enough troops to realistically make that happen. We still don't have a full troop of Royal Marine Commandos, so we've got two sections of Commandos and a fire team Special Boat Service. Since I'm not particularly happy with leaving a single section of the AI to take any given objective, we're going to be moving up as one unit, and we're going to try and seize these objectives one by one, utilising flanking manoeuvres from these hilltops to try and maximise our advantage from having a number of manoeuvre units. Should point out, we don't have a manoeuvre support unit, which means we're going to have to rely on more support from the base. Okay, let's get moving. I'm going to be sending one of the teams up here. That team is going to set up an overwatch on the northeast of the town. I'm going to have the other commando section move up with me on this mountain over here. Both of these will be raised points that we'll use to take out anyone in the town and then move in and deal with any prisoners from there. We'll probably just plonk the prisoners in the vehicles rather than taking them back to base at this point. That's a really terrible idea, mate. Why the hell are you driving on the road to do that? Oh god, no! No, 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 no. Dear lord, get the hell off the road. Idiots. Seriously, the AI is just the worst on this game. It's so stupid sometimes. Ignore that, that's a phantom. The actual trajectory of the unit is up this hill, so it looks like they haven't been engaged, which is good. It's night time, so the enemy probably know we're here now, but they don't know where we are just because they can't see us. I've got a ridgeback armoured vehicle. We're using mastiffs for the commandos, and that's going to be the fairly standard setup. We're not going to be using warriors until far later in the campaign, partly because of the cost in terms of resources, and partly because taking out a warrior doesn't make a huge amount of sense for what is supposedly an amphibious operation, at least early on. We're operating off a landing helicopter dock, not a some kind of great big dedicated LPD landing platform dock, so it makes more sense that way. What will probably happen in future is I'll be conducting most of these operations from a helicopter, probably a Westland, and leave the AI to do most of the heavy lifting. This is going to be especially true for the next big objective, which is a huge town, and taking that on by ourselves is definitely out of the question. We're going to need to use full combined arms, going to use the AI-5 darters, the UAVs, to recon the area, possibly do some flyovers beforehand, mortar strikes, anything we can to soften up the enemy, because there's probably about two platoons worth of strengths in that town. And we're also going to have to give away our presence by going into the oil factory first, which is a massive pain in the ass. What I might do is attack the oil factory with a section of special boat service forces, and then have the commandos go into this town. With any luck, the extra manpower from Layla and these two radio towers will give us the ability to procure a full troop worth of commandos, a full platoon's worth.
Hold fire! Down on fire!
I'm not expecting this to be too challenging for what is essentially an understrength troop. I don't think we'll have any big issues here, but we'll see. Sounds like somebody somewhere is trying to do something really stupid. They're not actually moving. Oh, there we go, finally. I think they were still getting out of their vehicle. Be very, very quiet. Very, very, very quiet. That's not ours, is it? No. Is that a civvy?
Contact car, 300 metres, southeast.
Is there anything on the right there? Oh, there's a civvy. That's a fuck ton of civvies. Jesus. Okay, definitely no mortar strikes on this location then. But, on the plus side, it doesn't look like there's many armed hostiles around here. We got that complex over there. We got... Since this is an extended operation, I'm not going to waste an N-Law taking out a rocket launcher. Taking out any of those shacks, I'll just shoot them. There's a guy needlessly pointing his gun at a civilian. What a douchebag. So we got those buildings, basically, our primary targets. Since we have a very good idea where the enemy are and we've got elevation and everything else, oh, and night vision, this should be a pretty much a cakewalk, even without dealing a blow to those. Again, if I was dealing with humans, I would probably, in fact I'm going to do it anyway, get the grenadier to pop a grenade in that hut will be a big advantage. No reason we should be having to fight those guys through the windows. Once these AI move up, I expect they'll engage automatically. I haven't told them not to. So we'll just get straight into the combat from there, I would imagine. Because the AI does move incredibly slowly if you tell it to move in stealth mode. Tell them to jump in and get ready for combat. Stop trying to be stealthy. Oh, yeah, that's a full squad, and they're now in our blind spot. That's really annoying. Screw it, we'll leave the other team to deal with that. We can always support them later. In fact, I'm going to suggest that our team move over here so we can deal with these guys in a nice crossfire. Hopefully not take out any of these civvies. I'll wait for the AI to start the engagement and then go on from there, I think. Although I am getting a bit worried that they're going to close in on our position if we don't engage very shortly. Lob. Enjoy these. That was quite clinical. Oop, still got one. Guy behind that tree from the looks of it, probably taken down by now. I'm not even sure that any of those AI units actually engaged. Didn't need them. Slowly close in on the town, make sure it's secure. And then we'll move up from there. I'm hoping the enemy doesn't counterattack, because we have a very limited ability to deal with that at the moment. If we do get counterattacked, I'm going to have to have one of the teams quickly jump in the Mastiff and cover this road and hope for the best. I think maybe if we can tie them down in Yanuka, have my guys garrison the buildings and then lay an ambush for them, probably the best strategy. This team as they're moving. Contact, rifleman. I have to say, what rifleman where? What are you blithering about? Where's the other team? Oh, bloody hell, they're taking forever. I think that combat's just completely got them by. I think we probably took everyone down with this fire team. Didn't even need the Marines. There's definitely still some troops in there though. Let's move down into this defilade here. There's probably one or two guys still in the vicinity. Don't want them getting caught out. Friendly. What? Why are you going in completely alone, you blithering fool? You apparently don't like that building. Alright. Let's get stuck in that building. Oop! Did we lose one of our own there? Let's very, very carefully clear these buildings. I don't wanna. What, where? Rifleman? Where's a rifleman? I can't see a rifleman. Wee-hee-hee! Why is this door not opening? That's really annoying. Really doesn't sound like we've captured Layla. It sounds like there's still a hell of a lot of combat going on. 100 meters.
just up ahead.
They're out on the outskirts. Not so bad. 100 meters. Whee! Grenade, I would assume. Really? Behind us? That would be surprising. Warning, friendly fire. Well, it sure as frick wasn't me doing any friendly fire. Oh, those are civvies. Right, that makes more sense. Okay. I don't think we actually took any prisoners on that one. Contact soldier. Where? I don't know where that soldier is. Looks like we might have taken a casualty. Is that one of ours? Yeah, shit, that's one of ours. Oh. Not much I can do about the AI being idiots. Unfortunately, the AI has no ability to clear urban areas whatsoever. Alright, I don't see any prisoners, so let's wrap up this wagon train and get somewhere useful. I lost one of my guys. What an idiot. Oh well. Vehicles and get moving on the second target. In fact, you guys go and do something different. I would like you lot to get roughly prepared over here. Save us some time later. Just make sure, sometimes they get stuck in combat mode and won't do anything else. And that makes them move incredibly slowly when you need them to get to the next objective. On the plus side, no counterattack. That's nice. Downside, no prisoners, which means no intel, which means we can't push down the enemy readiness by taking out their supplies and their bases. I really do hate taking the AI through those towns, because you can't move through methodically, the AI will just charge in, so you're kind of forced to go in Rambo style and pick everybody off. They'll never systematically clear out buildings because the AI doesn't communicate on that level, both in terms of the squad doesn't communicate on that level, and as a platoon they don't communicate between the squads on that level to let other squads know that a building's been cleared or whatever. It's a bit annoying, but what are you gonna do? No, it's probably your own guys, it usually is, or civilians. Civilian. No, you nearly got yourself run over, you idiot. Why are you guys not in the vehicle? Probably have me and a squad set up on Charlie, have a second one set up on Delta over there. Probably quicker to take the vehicles around the side. Nothing nice about just driving around in ARMA, like the sections between doing anything where you're just chilling out and driving around are quite therapeutic, quite enjoyable. It's nice to have a little bit of downtime. I mean, it's not like real levels of downtime, you're not spending 90% of your time in downtime, or 99% of your time in downtime, or even more than that, but it just punctuates the sections of loads and loads of combat quite nicely, and you still have to stay alert. You know, I'm still scanning around, checking the horizon, checking for any enemy threats, and might suddenly find myself having to completely change up my strategy and pay attention to things that I wasn't paying attention to before. And really, this vehicle can't get up that slope. Okay, let's get out. It's a bit pathetic, really, to be honest. I suppose it is basically a glorified Land Rover type thing. Really? Oh, fuck, I didn't tell you guys to get in the vehicle. That's why you stood around not being in a vehicle. See, the kind of thing that you don't need to tell a human to do, they'll just do it. Whereas if you're with the AI, you need to go through very specific steps. You need to tell them to move here, then you need to tell them to get in the vehicle, then get out of the vehicle, then move here, then go on overwatch, then hold fire, then go on stealth. It's not like you can just tell them, grab your vehicles, head over to Charlie and stay quiet. You know, that is a much better communication strategy, but you can't do that. And just generally, it's really hard to run military style operations without good communication. Good communication, good radio communication planning, etc., makes these kind of things go much more smoothly. In some ways, you're better off because you can give the AI orders via the map, you can give them precise orders as to where to go, you can tell them exactly what you want them to do, you can see where the enemy are on the map in relation, you don't have to do everything by grids. On the other hand, the AI themselves need very specific instructions and aren't even very good at following those. I mean, whilst I was getting this set up, the AI got stuck because the helicopter's still on the road here, and their pathing was telling them to go on the road and then follow the road, so they wouldn't go around the helicopter under any circumstances. I had to use MCC, Mission Control Center, I believe that's called, or Mission Command Center, and then had to teleport them over to here to fix the AI's stupidity, at which point they figured out what was supposed to be going on. Are you guys really stuck? Have you really managed to get your vehicle stuck? Hopeless. The other thing I can do, which I might do when we're dealing with the town over here, is I can switch to Zeus, and that'll give us a nice aerial view. I'll have the UAV as well, so we'll be able to see the bird's eye view from the UAV. But you can watch the combat going on Zeus, and that looks quite cool, and I think it'll be quite good for the video. They've managed to get the vehicle stuck, haven't they? Fuck's sake. Right, we'll have those guys move up to Delta, and then we'll very carefully have this unit move up behind us to Charlie, I think. Sounds like a plan. I hope they haven't got that Mastiff stuck. I can teleport the thing, so it's not too bad. I couldn't do that on the previous one, so when the AI ballsed up with the boats, I had to actually delete everything via Zeus and then start again, which wasn't great, but now I can cheat a bit. And for this operation, I've switched to the M27, which I think is just a designation for the Colt C8. I'm using a M16, basically. It's not actually an M16 or an M14, it's a Canadian carbine that's quite beloved. It's kind of a Commonwealth equivalent to the M14 carbine, but got it all pimped out with Riz and lasers and stuff. It's a shame you can't... They don't have an infinite number of attachment points, so you can't have, say, a flashlight and an IR and really tactical chav your weapon up. You're not allowed to do that. You have to only have the IR on there or only have a flashlight. But realistically, you don't need anything more fancy than that. Speaking of which, they don't have night vision. Or at least I don't think they have night vision. I didn't see night vision in any of the guys previously, so... We might as well use that. Yeah, no shit. I've also switched to using standard ARCO because that works with the night vision goggles, so I don't have to keep shooting in the dark. Rather than using a SUSAT or an ACOG or one of the other mod ones that doesn't work with the night vision, because it's just irritating having to switch away from the night vision. You can't get clear shots on anything at night at all, and realistically, if you weren't going to get that much advantage from the night, you weren't going to use those. And the AI is a bit funny in the way that it deals with night vision. It won't spot you at all if you're shooting it with suppressed weapons and flash hiders, but as soon as it sees a muzzle flash, it's like you've just been lit up completely, and it will be able to hone in on you and shoot you like nobody's business. So if you can keep the muzzle flashes hidden, you're invincible, and otherwise you don't have the advantage of night at all. It's a really stupid way they've done it. Ooh, this is interesting. This is positioning us in a jungle. I hadn't realised it was going to be this thick. I just thought it'd be a few trees. Which means I probably want to actually move up to there, take advantage of those trees, and position our forces in that area.
Hold fire! Still.
The sound effects between the Apex DLC and the JSRS mod that I'm now using, it just sounds so much better. Foot. All stealth. Foot. I suppose at least none of their branches are cracking underfoot. That would be embarrassing. It's getting light. So it's a bit jarring, is that suddenly it'll the sun will come up because it's only a 2-hour day cycle. So, hello, welcome to the day. What I thought was going to be a nighttime operation of me sneaking through these trees and very, very subtly engaging the enemy, it now really is not. You, person who's supposed to be being stealthy, what the fuck are you doing, sprinting? And you, divot. Fucking special boat service, my ass. I don't think, based on the terrain here, now they're not going to be able to see shit. There's trees and there's fucking defilade in the way. They're not going to be able to engage at all. Let's move them along here. Nope, that's higher than they are, so they're not going to be able to engage like that. We probably want them to move in with us. I mean, the optimal way to do it would be to have my team come down that hill, pop them with grenades, maybe a mortar, then have the other team here. One nice thing is that they probably don't have any civilians in this area, so I should, in theory, that's a stupid place to stop. I should, in theory, be able to call down mortar strikes on these buggers. But it's going to be hard to confirm
contact,
that.
Man, 100 meters, right up ahead. Contact, man, 100 meters, right up ahead.
Also, at 100 meters, that would definitely be danger close. Not necessarily something I want to do. That's where the bulk of them are. I'm half tempted to just let my troops get into position, let them engage, and then just pile into them. I think we could actually have a rather embarrassingly good initial engagement if I just let the AI do its thing. And oh my god, where the hell are you guys going? I really hope the grenade launcher guy pops them. That would make this very satisfying. Again, I'd like to use the end law, but I want to save it just in case there's any armour, particularly if there's a counter-attack. I'll want to use it to take out the mechanised forces. Since we don't have the manoeuvre support group, we don't have like a javelin or anything, so it's good to keep the light anti-tank, the end laws, available and around. Ooh, that's nice, I like that.
Move right.
And this little mound here, that'll be perfect. Am I the only one who hears a helicopter? I really do not like that sound at all. We may just want to attack very quickly and then retreat very, very quickly, possibly even without taking prisoners. Or at least get the commandos out of harm's way. Because if that's an enemy transport helicopter, we're in for a world of hurt. Actually, it could just be a conventional vehicle taking over, like an MRAP or something, which apparently stands for Ambush Protected. Mine Resistant Ambush Protected, not whatever bullshit I was talking about last time. Let's have the forces move in! Attack! Whee! And why did that make me jump? There's no reason that should have made me jump at all. Fuck you! Fuck you, fuck you as well, fuck the lot of you. Oh yeah, I haven't told my guys to engage. Oops. Fire at that building with the prisoners and the civilians. because we've defeated all of the enemies. Why would we do that? That's a terrible idea. Let's not murder all the civilians. And yep, that's definitely a helicopter. That's definitely a helicopter. Get the fuck out of Dodge, people. Leave my guys to deal with this. I want that prisoner, like, really badly. Oh, that, no, it's not a helicopter, it's a fucking go-kart! Seriously! Seriously, fuck you. Bloody bleeding hell. Let's have to cover me whilst I get these prisoners then. I agree.
Six. Join group. Six. Fall back. Two. Three. Fall back.
I hope I've got room in the ridgeback for all of these guys. If not, I might have to make an off-video detour to go and take these guys back. It's a pretty game. It's a very pretty game. Why is that guy waiting? Nobody told you to wait, we told you to regroup.
Six, fall back. Six, move 700 meters northwest.
Why is this guy not following my orders? Quite annoying. Oh, we'll just follow him instead of the other way around. Congratulations, you're now a human shield. Not what I originally intended. Really? Really? No, you want to be on this side of the decalade, not that side. That's enfilade. Enfilade is bad. He's taking a very circuitous route to this vehicle. Always a good idea when you're in the middle of wide open enemy territory to actually pay attention to your surroundings. Hey! Paid off. No. That's a terrible idea. Don't want to engage them yet. Did they actually hear that? Yes, but they didn't pinpoint us. Probably thinks it's a sniper attack. Phew. That's good. No worse ways that could have played out, certainly. Also, according to this, there's an enemy force just down the hill. I'm going to have to carefully investigate that. he says, running directly out into the open like a divot. Relying too much on the map there. Are they in that? And past the trees. Okay. Again, I really wish I could communicate with the AI and ask them, is it beyond the trees that you saw this guy? Or what did you see precisely? Was it the guy that we sent that way? Which it probably is. Oh yeah, he's run off. What a twat. So yeah, that'll be the guy, one of the prisoners has decided to run off in that direction. Which is fine, it was bugged anyway, and he probably wouldn't fit in the vehicle. And these guys are clearly not moving at the proper speed at all. I also need to tell them not to needlessly engage. And I also need to remember to set them to engage later. Solves that problem. I'm pretty sure there's something in the Geneva Convention about not doing that, but oh well. You've got a fair chunk of ammunition, that's 590 ammunition, that's nearly enough to get us an F-35B for close air support, which is what we unlocked when we took that airfield. That would be cool, although I'll probably spend it on more conventional weapon systems like a Challenger tank. And maybe even consider some Warriors. I'd quite like to bank some of the ammunition for later. The way I've got it set up, you have to pay ammunition just to bring the special boat service guys in, which is why initially I was using the commandos rather than the special boat service.
Unknown contact, half a click, due north.
Stiffy, I would imagine. Got what is almost certainly a civilian vehicle. Yup. And thought I saw. Yeah, person over there as well. Civvy. Okay. Not to worry. Where's the... Oh, the bloody... The prisoner mechanics on this really don't work. One of the prisoners has just disappeared completely. I have no idea why. Possibly because we ran slightly too far ahead and he didn't feel like keeping up. Not babysitting them, Jesus. Want to make sure that the prisoner doesn't get one of the decent seats. Okay, well, since the enemy now know that we're coming, that's going to make this a little bit more interesting. The fact that they're on the top of the hill also going to make this a little bit more interesting than it would otherwise be. decided, I think, possibly we might just engage from range from over here. There's not a great amount in terms of terrain. There's kind of two options here. I can push up through these trees and just have our forces force our way up the hill, or we could try to pick them off through here, which probably won't work because this looks like really thick foliage. It looks like the only reasonable way to attack it is from the west. So I'll have my troops pull up here behind the cover of these trees. Pay close attention to the road to make sure nobody sneaks in behind us, and push up with all of the force simultaneously through to that radio tower. Hoping as well that they don't choose to engage that patrol whilst they're still in the vehicle. That would be less than ideal. As a driver, I should be paying attention to the road more than I am doing, but thought people might want to get some beauty shots of some of the British armed vehicles, which you don't see very often in ARMA videos, particularly in ARMA3. I mean, ARMA2 had the British Armed Forces expansion, which means that a lot of people are used to seeing like Land Rover Defenders and stuff from that, but ARMA3, these three commando brigade models look significantly better than anything that's in ARMA 2 or in the community upgrade project mod. Whew, I've been worried for a second there. I'm going to leave the prisoner in the vehicle. I'm assuming that he's going to be there with his air guitar, not causing any problems. I can't help but notice that one of the vehicles is not here. Sigh. Let's go and do a little bit of scouting. There's nothing in the general vicinity that might cause us problems. Not expecting anything, but it's worth checking. It's not so much of a problem yet, with only 17% readiness. Once their alertness increases, I expect to be paying much more attention to the surroundings and having forces moving up, supporting our operations, like in the back here, just making sure that we don't get counterattacks that take us completely by surprise. As it is at the moment, we can focus pretty much entirely on the offense, and if we keep getting prisoners, we can hopefully keep the value pretty low in the long term as well. What are they doing? This might be another case of magically teleporting those people.
Still. Move out. Go.
Now I know that there's a team that was here that's moving up there, so they're probably walking around the hill in a clockwise pattern, which means I really want to keep my eyes out and make sure we don't just suddenly get attacked from the southeast. Like it's time for some teleportation. Not ideal. Like I say, I really need to... Oh, the prisoners somehow escaped from the vehicle because stupid game logic. That is really annoying. I'm gonna keep his eyes open just in case anyone comes poking the head around the side. Normally I'd just take the prisoners straight back to the base without any more fiddling, but I don't want to do that on the videos because watching me do a pointless vehicle run isn't exactly exciting. That was a very Captain Kirk delivery. Covering fire! The way that the audio's done for the AI has always been a little bit suspicious in ARMA games. Would you believe that this is the best it's ever been by quite a long way? Somebody's engaged somewhere. Shit. Again, this is one of those where you want really, really want to get on the radio and ask who's shooting at what. But because they're AI, they won't tell you. So I literally have to walk up to them to see which way they're shooting. Defilade. Oh, they're shooting at a former prisoner. Fair enough. Screw that guy. Well, there goes all of the stealthiness I was hoping for. Completely. The little things in the... little niggles in the game where it's just not very sensible. Thank you. that's not good. Got some kind of shack. We'll be careful when we approach that. I think I have a grenade. I do have a grenade. Excellent. Again, it's a military installation, shouldn't be any civilians here. Forge SRS sounds good. That was a nice meaty explosion. Switch to fully automatic just in case we get engaged close up. Okay, we see the radio tower, no problem, but there's probably that patrol squad somewhere. Definitely coming from an easterly direction. Kaboom. Still set not to shoot. That's a very bad thing for them to be doing. I don't fancy standing up in any of this, not knowing where the enemy actually are. Well, mission accomplished. If I can get those prisoners back, we should be able to launch a logistics op in the future, or pretty close. We're going to also have to spend some time scouting out this oil factory, working out what kind of forces they have in Katkoula, and carefully planning the attack into that, but that's all going to come in the next episode. So, thank you very much. That was Operation Urban Sword, much shorter than the last one, and nice, quick, simple special forces kind of grabbing some objectives. So, I'll see you next time. Cheers!